Serendipity is a marvelous thing. I stumbled across these metal tags while searching for something else and knew they would be perfect for all kinds of mixed media creating. In today's video, I'll show you some fun ways to work with them, including adding color with alcohol, ink, paint, adding texture with embossing folders, and with a stylus. Link to the products can be found in the expanded description below. Don't forget to use the Create with Joggles hashtag. When I found these tags, I was just struck with the various possibilities, the almost limitless possibilities about ways to use them and work with them. Now, the interesting thing to know is that though these are metal, they are in fact flexible, and they will to some extent hold whatever shape you flex them into. So this is 14mm cardstock core that's wrapped with 2mm of aluminum on both sides. Now this aluminum is soft, so you can see that it'll kind of flex and hold its shape, but not only is it soft enough to do that, you can use a pen or a pencil or a stylus and emboss, deboss, put some pattern on here, and it will stay. The metal is soft enough to hold whatever you do to it. So for example, here is a stylus. If I want to just go ahead and make marks in here, not only can I do that, but I can flex and move this thing around, and that mark is going to remain there. So this becomes really important when you think about things like embossing folders. So before we get there, let's talk about the four that we have. So this is the smallest. It's 1 inch wide by 3 1/4 inches tall. This is the next to the smallest. It's 1 5/8 by 3 1/8. We have this one that is 2 3/8 by 4 7/8, and this one's easy, it's just 3 by 5. Now, since they're metal, you have to think about what you're going to use on the surface. Sprays are not going to work because they're not meant for non-porous surfaces, and that's what this is because it's metal. But paint. Think about all of the paints that you use. Dina Wakely's paints, the Amsterdam acrylics, Tim's paints, Golden paints, Diane's paints. All of those paints are multi-surface, so they will actually adhere to the metal. But most importantly, the thing that I think presents the most possibilities is stuff like alcohol ink. Because this is metal, you can do all kinds of really cool things with it. So let me bring out some samples. Whoops, let's knock a bunch of stuff over. All right. So this is one, you can see it's been embossed. Not super pretty, but there's work yet to be done on it. This is one where I added paint, embossed it, and then added some more paint on top. This, however, is quite beautiful. This is alcohol ink. I put alcohol ink on the tag, did some stuff to maneuver it around, and then I embossed it. Here's one that just has alcohol on the tag, and then I put some ink on it and let it do its thing. Here are some more examples of embossed tags with alcohol ink. And here's one where, and I'm going to show you this at the very end, where I used a stylus to trace a stencil design, put some glitterific in the center, painted some alcohol ink in the petals, and it was done. And when you get these done, you can do all kinds of really fun things with them. Now this one is a giant mishmash. This one has paint, alcohol ink, and lunar paste on it. This was the first one I really got into working on, and though I'm not going to actually repeat this, I am going to show you how to work with paint, alcohol ink, and at the very end I'll show you how I can add some lunar paste to this and kind of get it down into all of those crevices. So I'm going to start with alcohol ink because it is so beautiful on these tags and because it's just so much fun to play with. So I'm going to use, this is the next to the largest tag that is 2 3/8 by 4 7/8. So when you do this, you have a couple of options. You can either add the alcohol ink first and then emboss it, or you can emboss it and add the alcohol, excuse me, you can, yes, emboss it and then add the alcohol ink after the fact. So I'm going to start this one by putting some alcohol ink on, and it dries pretty quickly, so then I'll take it and emboss it. But in the meantime, I have some alcohol in a container and an eyedropper, and I'm just going to put some alcohol on here. Now, I can do it this way, or I have a spray bottle of alcohol. I've got enough on here, but I have a spray bottle of alcohol that I can go ahead and apply this to, and I actually get a little bit better coverage with the spray bottle because it puts alcohol everywhere. Okay, so I'm going to stick with a couple of colors. This is Sunshine Yellow and Gumball. Both are Ranger Tim Holtz alcohol inks. So you've probably seen plenty of people demo with alcohol ink, but what I'm going to do is put some drops on here, and then I'm going to let gravity and the alcohol do the work for me. All right. so let's just go ahead and let this move around. And the nice thing is you don't have to overblend. It really, however much you want to move it around is entirely up to you. So I've got quite a lot of color on here. Let me grab a paper towel and I'm going to just tip some of it off. Now as I lose some of that color, I can add some more back up here at the top if I want and let it run down. I can make these kind of stripy patterns, and this all plays into whatever the final pattern is and how it looks when you emboss it. So as far as I'm concerned, that's pretty much ready to go. So give me a second and I'm going to take this to one side, I'm going to dry it, and then I'm going to go emboss it and I'll bring it back so that you can see it. I used Tim's embossing folder named Entangled, and this is what you get once it's embossed. Now, as cool as this is, you can take this one step further and I think make it a little bit better. I'm going to use a little bit of alcohol on a paper towel and I'm going to lightly lift the color off of the raised areas. So I'm just going to go ahead, and I'm not soaking this with alcohol by any stretch of the imagination. I don't want to take too much off. So I've got my alcohol and I'm just going to very lightly rub this over the top. Well, I guess I didn't put quite enough alcohol on. I'm going to rub this very lightly over the top and start to remove some of the color. Now, I'm doing this slowly because I tried doing it quickly and not so much. It didn't work real well because I ended up taking off more color than I meant to. I find I have a little bit more control this way. So I can go ahead and spray again. And then I can start to take some of the color off here. Now you can see I had too much alcohol on there, so I've really lightened that quite a bit. You can do as much or as little of this as you like. If you don't feel it needs it, then by all means don't do it. You have to do what works for you and what you like. But I like this look. I think it makes things quite a bit more interesting because now the pattern is so much more obvious. Up next, I'm going to show you what happens when you emboss the tag first, and then you add either alcohol ink or paint. It's really fun. Adding color after a tag has been embossed results in a different look. It's subtle, but it's definitely worth doing. I don't want my stuff to all be samey-samey, and if there's even a subtle way to change something, I'm going to try it. So I have two tags that are embossed. This is the largest and the next to the largest. This is done with Courtney Chilson's Texture Fade that's named Mosaic Gems, and that's this one. And this is from Tim. It's named Mechanics. And that's what this one looks like. So I'm going to start with Mechanics and start with some paint. Got a couple of colors of Dina Wakely's paint. Now, remembering that virtually all paint is multi-surface. Sprays are a whole different story. They're probably not going to work unless it's something like Dina's gloss sprays. But if you're working with paint, most of the time it's multi-surface. So I'm going to put a little bit of both colors out. I have turquoise and heather, and I have a little bit of a plug in that one. So let me just poke that out so that the paint can flow. There we go. All right, so I have a little bit of turquoise, and I have, this one is heather. And this is probably more paint than what I needed. Now, obviously, paint takes a little bit of time. It's not like alcohol ink that's a solvent base and just evaporates. So I have one off to the side that I think is going to be dry enough to use when the time comes. Now, if I really spread this out, you can see that the paint has a tendency to be a little bit transparent. It's not a porous surface, so the paint doesn't grab in quite the same way. But I can apply it a little bit more heavily if I want and get some more immediate coverage that way. Now, obviously, the heavier you apply the paint, the longer it's going to take to dry because it's only drying from the top. The metal underneath is not allowing, that's too much turquoise, is not allowing the liquid in the paint to evaporate through the back like it would on a porous surface. So that's just, again, one of those things that you kind of keep in mind as you go along. And you can use a heat tool gently, not, you know, you don't want to roast it because paint is plastic and it's not going to be super happy if you roast it with a heat tool. But you can certainly waft a heat tool over it to get it to go ahead and dry for you. And I don't like waiting either, so I am completely in sympathy when you're standing there tapping your toe because the darn thing's not dry yet. All right, let's put a little bit of this up here. Now, as I said, I've got one off to the side that I think is almost dry. So there's some good color on there. You can see the pattern underneath and then the color. I'm going to push that out of the way because it will not dry in time for me to do anything with it, but the one that I have off to the side should. But we'll let that continue to dry, and I'm going to bring out the mosaic gems and some alcohol. So, an alcohol ink. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to spray alcohol on the surface here, which allows the alcohol ink to flow a little bit more. And I've got a couple of colors. I have Laguna, and this is Lettuce. And I've got some eggplant off to the side, which is a really deep purple. I'm not certain if I'm going to use it, but we'll play and see what happens. Now, interestingly enough, when you do this with alcohol and alcohol ink on something that's already embossed, you're going to find that the color has a tendency to sit down in all of the depressed or debossed areas, which is about what you'd expect, and that's why you're going to get a different look. Now, with that said, I can use more alcohol if I need to get things to move around, but you can already see what happens when you do this. The color starts to accumulate in those lower debossed areas, and again, this is what I mean by an entirely different look. If I want to add some more lettuce up here, I can. Of course, I can add more alcohol, which I'm going to do now. I'll just spritz some on here, and that will get things moving. So I really like this look. Now, there's nothing that says you can't come back with a paper towel that's been dampened with alcohol the same way that I did the last time. Let's just grab a paper towel here. I can do the same thing if I want to lift some color off of the raised areas, or if I even want to scrub it out of those debossed areas a little bit. All right, let's go ahead and get this running over there. And you can see this is pretty well covered at this point, and I like it. I don't even think I'm going to bother adding any of the eggplant because I think it looks great just the way it is. And I've got this one area in the center where it's very light because there's only a little bit of ink in it. And again, I'm good with that. I like the way that that looks. We've got a little bit more ink accumulating here that I'm just going to go ahead and drain off. And let's put that to one side and let it dry. All right. So now if I bring in the tag, this is the mechanics that I have already put the paint on and let it dry. I'm going to grab a clean paper towel. Now, the cool thing about paint is that on something like metal, where it's not really stuck into the surface because it's not porous, you can use alcohol, even paint that's really, really dry, to rub some of it off. So again, I'm just going to lightly come in here with the alcohol and let it and only a little bit of pressure kind of do the work for me. Now, obviously, alcohol will evaporate out of the paper towel, so I'll have to come back and add some more, but that's okay. And if it's not moving enough, I can add a little bit more pressure. I mean, that's kind of the way that you feel your way through this to see how it's going to work. Again, time for a little bit more alcohol. And it's always your choice about how much of the color you choose to lift. It's a personal preference thing. Maybe it's project specific. Maybe you want to lift a lot off for one project and only a little for another. So I'm just going to clean this little bottom bit up here, and now this is ripe for something else. Now I could come in and I could put ink over it if I wanted to and let it kind of all settle into the grooves, or I could come in with some Lunar Paste. So I have, this is the Luna paste that's named Prom Queen, and I'm going to, that alcohol is pretty much evaporated off there. So what I'm going to do is work out of the cover, and I'm going to go ahead and put it on here. And if I think that this is a little bit too much, I can come with a paper towel and start to rub it off. So you can change things up a little bit. Now, remembering that this is water-based, for this, if I want to do a little bit of cleanup, not lifting, but cleanup, I can put some water on here and I can start to lift that off. And now you can see that I've got color all the way down in the background. That's what I did for this tag. This has one of the Art by Marlene characters on it. This was one where I went around and around and around, and I added color and I rubbed it off, and I added more color and I rubbed it off. So you can experiment with these, and as I said, you can really change the look depending on what you do with it once the color, whether it's ink or paint, is dry. Okay, so the last thing for today, and just let me cap these alcohol inks, In case I knock them over, they won't spill everywhere. The last thing for today is how you can use a stylus and a stencil to create something like that. So I have this is our stencil named Sunflowers. I've got one of the big tags. I did the next to the largest, so I'm going to do the largest one here. And I'm not going to cover the whole tag, but I want you to see how easy this is. So in Wendy Vecchi's Make Art line, there are two sets of styluses. You have this one, which is set number two, and then set number one has the black and the white, and you can see that these are the smaller of the tips. I'm going to use the white one, but not the tiniest tip, the one that's a little bit bigger. And all you have to do is line this up where you want it to be, and I think that looks pretty good. And then it's just a matter of using the stylus, to trace the outline of the openings in the stencil, which debosses them into that soft surface that is the aluminum, and there they sit. They're not going anywhere. Now, for the sample, for this one, I came back with Glitterific Pop paint and put it in the center, which is what all that lovely glitter is. But for this one, and then I painted with alcohol ink, I painted just on a brush, I painted those petals. But with this one, I'm going to do something a little bit different, and I'm going to create some texture. And this is just a sample, so I'm not going to finish all the way around this. Oops. At this point, I'm not going to finish anything if I don't hold that straight. So what I'm going to do, some days you just want to go back to bed. Okay, so now I've got this on here, but here's where things are going to get a little bit interesting. Rather than leave that plain petals like I did here, I'm going to take my stylus tool and just kind of do some zigzags so that when I put the alcohol on here, it now has a lower place to settle into, in much the same way as the ones that I embossed with the embossing folders did. So I'm going to grab a brush. I've got a little palette here. Let me grab a brush, and someplace here I have some yellow alcohol ink. I'm going to put a little bit in here, and I just want to show you what happens when you have an embossed pattern like this. So you can see that pattern that's in there. It's obviously the shape of the petals, but it also is the design. And so when I apply, well, it would help if I stayed inside the lines. When I apply this alcohol like this, it really emphasizes the pattern that's in there. So you have something where you can really see the pattern, as opposed to this, where you've got nice smooth petals. And does it matter which one you do? Nope, it's really all about what works for you or the project that you're in the process of creating. So, you know, playing with these metal tags, I was just so flabbergasted when I found them because I was so excited about the possibilities, and I'm not disappointed. This is the barest kind of beginnings of what you can do with this. I've had a great time. I hope you have just as much fun when you play with them.